This is a one-fall contest. Introducing in the ring, weighing in at 275 pounds, the mighty Hercules. His opponent, soon to be making his way to the ring area from San Francisco, California, weighing 269 pounds, the Pervert Beefcake.
On their feet here in Milwaukee, and Brutus the Barber making his way down. Take a look, Brain. What a huge, enormous crowd here at County Stadium for this World Wrestling Federation event. With the Brewers are eating their hearts out. You can never do 60 people. At least 60,000 plus on hand here. The good front office here, though. Good people are working. I've given you a lot of the Brewer games, but I'm pretty busy. I'm trying to find a replacement for Euchre, I guess.
Well, I understand that you and Euchre had a big falling out. Is that...
He didn't have a big falling out. He just... I shouldn't sit in the front row.
Oh. Third man in the ring, Dave Hebner, one of the premier referees here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Well, he's great.
Brutus got some strange looking clothes.
Strange looking man. He's a strange man. I guarantee you he will not cut the hair of Hercules.
Well, Herc doesn't need a haircut. Did you ever see Brutus try to clip somebody's hair that didn't need it?
Yeah.
Who?
Well, I can't think right offhand. He's got the weapons out there with him. He must need them for something or thinks he needs them.
Well, you never know. These matches, who's going to stick their nose into somebody else's business?
The people cheer when you see Herc's body.
Bell's gone. We're underway.
Is this a crowd or is this a crowd?
Oh, this is a biggie. Of course, anything after WrestleMania, when we had, 93,000 plus in the Silverdome and Pontiac?
I don't want to talk about that.
I don't want to discuss that. Sorry. Sorry I even mentioned it. Brutus the Barber Beefcake with a date with Destiny just 2 weeks away as part of SummerSlam 88. Golden opportunity for him to become the next reigning Intercontinental Champion and strip the Honky Tonk Man of the gold.
And cut his hair off.
And give him a haircut.
That's what he wants to do. And maybe the last time you see Brutus Beefcake.
What do you mean?
I guarantee he's not going to win that title. He's not going to cut the hair of the Honky Tonk Man. And I'll tell you what Hercules is going to do.
He's going to get bitten by Damien, probably.
He's not going to get bitten by Damien. He's going to tie that snake in a knot. He's going to tie Jake the Snake Robertson a knot, and then he's going to go right down the ringside and look right in the eye of Cheryl Roberts and say, no, I'm taken for the evening, and walk away.
Who does he think he is?
Remember the Bobby Heenan family.
It's a ride. Look out. Ducks in the ring. A nice clothesline. A couple of blocks, and Bruce and Rhoda are both unloading now. But nobody's delivering the blow.
Oh. Come on, Hurt.
Hercules on the receiving end of those big roundhouse rights. And an elbow right on the cranium. And he's out of there.
Good move, yeah. And you've been turn around and I'm not here. There's a phone call I have to make.
Why aren't you down there?
Because I have my cameraman sitting right next to me, as you can see. And I like to film from different vantage points. All the confidence in the world that hurts me. I don't have to always be in
it would appear to me that a match of this magnitude, if I were the man's manager, I would in fact be down at ringside.
You want me to leave?
I didn't say
just
that.
Just say so. You want me to leave? Just say so.
Oh, I guess if you don't think it's important to you to be there, don't be there.
I don't want to do this without me.
A lot of signs. Can't quite make an offering from this distance.
It takes me quite some time to get through all these people from the ring located.
Well, do you want to go? Go ahead. Don't you? Wouldn't bother me.
You want me to go?
Do whatever you want to do.
Tell me if you want me to go.
I didn't want you to come to begin with. Hercules, one of the powerhouses in the world of professional wrestling. I put him right up there in the ranks of Dino Bravo, The Rock Morocco, Andre the Giant. Andre's in that category, you know.
Andre is ahead of that category. He don't want to go. He don't go.
I guess not.
That's that old story. You know where he sleeps?
Any place he desires.
That's right. You know where he beats up?
Anybody
he wants
well,
to.
Except Hulk Hogan.
You see the Hulk Hogan, all right? And the Macho Man.
Well, he'll get a chance at both of them in just a couple of weeks. Madison Square Garden will be the location. A Monday night, August 29th, SummerSlam 88.
I didn't tell you, DiBiase is going to throw the biggest party in the history of New York City.
Why would the losers want to have a party?
Well, that's the way you see it. He's not going to be a loser. Yeah. He's flying into special champagne for Andre. He's got the whole top floor rented. I want to go over to the Houston Hotel, which I can't tell right now. You'll show up at the door, hat in hand, begging for a...
Trump Towers?
I didn't say that.
I know you didn't. I did. Is that where the party's going to be?
You want to hang out Trump Towers? I used to be there.
Up on the roof garden? Up.
It's by invitation only. It doesn't matter if you found out where we're going to be.
I didn't say I knew where it was going to be. I'm just taking a wild guess.
You're going to show up one more day with bananas and stuff.
No, I have my own plans. I'll be fairly exhausted after that evening, I'm sure.
That means you'll be out all night cabaret, right?
No, I won't be out cabaret. Good eye. Getting stomped on here and stomped on and belted by Hercules.
He looks like much of a barber now. Call Salvo Feroli back. Maybe he'll give you the plumber back.
It's Salvadori Fedora.
All sounds the same to me.
Well. Oh. Things not going too well right now for Brunei. Has Herc really doing a number on him here with this reverse chin lock.
Beautiful weather, too. See, the barber, it's a little different when he's in there with somebody that's a little bigger than him or a little tougher. Like the Honky Tonk Man. See, the Honky Tonk Man has dominated every match they've had.
Are you saying that Honky is bigger and tougher and better?
No, I'm saying he's better and he's dominated every match they've had.
What's wrong with the right arm of Herc?
His right arm.
Hey, it's all bandaged up.
I believe he's trained a muscle working out.
He did.
Yeah. But he won't use it. He won't, there's nothing in that arm.
No. Just gauze wrapped around it.
Just to protect an eighth bandage and a little tape just to protect the measure.
Tell me about it. Really not a bad seat in this stadium, is there?
Oh, I think there is one.
We're talking about that one obstructed vision seat there.
Right behind the pole. That's where Hogan's going to be sitting from now on. And Macho Man at all the ball games.
Is that right?
You won't want anybody to see his face after they're embarrassed on August 29th. He'll be hiding out. He'll be in New York at a party. He'll be in some sleazy hotel room with the dress.
Oh, almost a three count on Blue Eye.
Come on, if he'd have counted, we'd have had it.
Yeah. Why don't you go down there? Get involved.
You want me to go?
Go ahead. By the time you made it there, I guarantee you, the match would be over.
Tell me if you want me to go.
Go ahead.
I'm not going.
Take your height.
Leave you here alone to make fun of Hercules and call the action wrong?
Brunei with that pained expression on his face.
Everybody got dressed up today in Milwaukee. This guy's got on his clean and dirty shirt.
Why are you always picking on people?
That guy, when he checks out at a restaurant, they don't give him a check. They look at his shirt and say, well, you've had the bratwurst and you've had the extra chili on the top dog.
Things going quite well here for Hercules. But the tank is not empty yet. That left arm
keep
is
him
up
down, Herc. Keep him down.
Brunei struggles, gets back to his feet.
Come on, come on.
Got that old adrenaline flowing now.
He's too strong for him, Monsoon. He's living good. Hold him, Herc.
Two elbows downstairs and a couple of more. Finally breaks it loose.
Come on, Herc.
Brunei has come to life.
Is that real phone up here now? Is it on the inside?
There's no phone here.
There's a headset I can use.
Why don't you just run down there? Caught in mid. good hit. Whoa. Big roundhouse. Found the mark. Irish whip into the corner. Boy, did he hit hard. How quick the tide can turn in the world of professional wrestling.
Use the arm. Use the arm.
He can't hear you. Can you see? You honestly believe he can hear you?
I'll be right back.
60,000 screaming fans, and you're looking for him to hear you from this position.
Go ahead of me and clear an aisle.
Can't leave this position.
Now, why don't the referee stop him? He's just doing nothing but throw punches and broke every rule. Look at that. Punch.
Nice uppercuts, one after the other.
Nice uppercut. Another punch.
All coming right along with Rudolph.
I'm amazed that 60,000 people in Milwaukee have been punching for him.
Oh, nice leverage move. Desperation.
Piece of cake.
Nice move by Hurt.
Nothing to worry about. I told you.
Oh, now you're relaxed. Now you're sitting back. You're not on the edge of your chair now.
You're going to block my right.
There it is. Slapped it on.
Ring the bell.
The full Nelson. Has he got those fingers locked? I can't tell from here. No, he's not got them locked. And Rudolph manages to escape.
Referee should have called him.
Oh, there's a sleeper.
He's choking him.
Slapped it on right in the center of the ring.
He's choking him.
I don't know whether he's strong enough to hold it. Oh, he had a turn of loose. Oh, look at this.
I'm going down.
Fighting through the backside. He got it.
I'm going downstairs.
Goodbye. Whoa, what an upset victory. Here in Milwaukee, the Brutus the Barber Beefcake. He came around the back door. Here's the official word.
The winner of this bout, Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
Here in Milwaukee. What a victory. Well, it was really quite simple. He outsmarted Mercury. The brain is on his way down there. He didn't make it. Look, he's got that 15-foot chain. The brain hasn't made it down there yet. What's Rudolph got? Got the shears. Gonna do a little shearing. Well, keep going, Hurt. You'll find the brain. You'll run right into him on the way there. There's a hand raise and a token of victory. Upset, going home with the short end of the money. Hercules. Oh, the brain will be all over him like a new suit. There it is here. Slaps the sleeper on. Had him right where he wanted him, right here. But Hercules, with that fantastic power of his, manages to run right into the corner. Look at that. Had to turn him loose, but Hurt still a little dazed, got caught in that reverse sunset. Referee right there to make the three count, and it was all over. Plenty more action still to come from Milwaukee, Wisconsin. We'll be back in just a moment.